The query function is one of the most powerful functions in Google Sheets because it can solve your simpler problems, but also your more complex data analysis problems. Now, because it has all this flexibility, it can feel like a difficult function to really understand. If you start learning the query function by jumping in and watching tutorials about the more complex use cases, you're going to get lost. If you take a little bit of time to understand the basics and understand the set of rules that you need to follow, it's going to be a piece of cake to master this function. The first important rule with the query function is the set of clauses that you can use. These are similar to SQL. What's important is that you respect the order of the clauses. Now, these are optional, you don't have to use all of them, but the order is important. There is more information in this link here. I'm just going to bring it up to show you how it looks. I recommend that you go through this and study this if you're planning to use the query function. So the clauses that I showed you before are right here. Here's the important part. All clauses are optional, clauses are separated by spaces, and the order of the clauses must be as follows. You also have more information about each clause here. Now, you also have the ability to write aggregation functions in your query function. And you can see the list of different aggregation functions available and the syntax you need in here. You can also use scalar functions like year, month, day, and so on. The full list is here. And in addition, you have arithmetic operations like the usual operations that we can use on the grid. You can use that inside the query function. So let's start off by writing our first query. I'm going to write it to the side here. Now, my data is sitting in a data tab. It's from column A to E. I have scenario, app, division, revenue, and cash. Now, this information goes all the way to line 121. Let's go to the query tab here and write our first very simple query function. First thing I need is my data that's sitting in the data tab. Now, you can just select the range where you have data, or you can select entire columns. So I'm going to select all of this because I don't want to worry about where my data ends. Now, next here is the query itself. This is where you're going to write your clauses, and they have to go in quotation marks like we see in the example here. So I'm going to write a very simple one. Just select everything. Everything is represented by the asterisk symbol. Now I'm just going to close the quotation. The last argument is the number of headers I have. If you omit this or you set it to -1, the value is guessed based on the content of data. Now I'm going to put a 1 just to be sure because I have one row of headers. Close the bracket, press enter, and I get everything back. My query function has very simple syntax. It just says select everything. Now let's take this a step further and specify the columns that we want to select. The syntax for this is the column letter. So if you're using the query function on a data set within the same workbook, you need to use column letters. If you're using the query function inside the import range function and importing data from another spreadsheet, like we've seen in a previous video, you need to use column numbers. In this case, I'm getting data from the same file. It's just sitting in a different tab here. All I have to do is select the letters of the columns I want to get. So for example, I'm going to go with A and then comma. Let's get C and then B and then just E. So notice the order can be in any order that you want. Now when I press enter, I get scenario first, then division, then app, and then cash. So these column letters are the column letters where my data is sitting in. Scenario is in A, division in C, app in B, and cash in E. Now let's take this a step further and do more complex queries by aggregating some of the columns. So I'm going to jump to the data tab and continue with our examples here. It's just easier to keep our results on the same page as the data set because it's easier to compare in the video. I don't have to switch back and forth between the different tabs. The next query function I want to write is to get scenario by the sum of revenue and sum of the cash column. So I have three different scenarios. I have actual, budget, and outlook one. How would I write this? Well, I also pasted our clauses here so we can respect the order of the clauses. I'll start off with the query function. First thing was the data, then is my query, and then the optional argument on how many header rows I have. My data, I'm going to go with A to E. The query, in quotation marks, type in select. I want scenario, so that's A, and then the sum of D and sum of E. So here I can use my aggregation functions. First the comma, and then sum in brackets D, comma, sum of E. Now, if I just close this with a quotation mark, close the bracket and press enter, what am I going to get? Now, before I do that, take a look to see if you're subscribed to this channel. If you aren't, consider subscribing. Now take a look at this. When I press enter, I'm going to end up with an error. Why? Well, because I'm summing these columns, but I'm returning the entire A column. I need to use another clause here, and that's the group by clause. Group by comes after select. So add a space here, go with group by. I want to group this by A. Now when I press enter, I get actual by the sum of revenue and sum of cash. Now it appears that these cells were already pre-formatted. This one isn't. Now when you use the query function, you get the data back in general format unless you manually format your cells the way you want, or you can also use the format clause inside the query function to format your data on the fly. Now also notice that here I have an empty row. This is because I'm including the entire column and there are a lot of empty rows on the bottom here. I want to get rid of that in my report. This is where I can use the where clause. Notice the order. Where is between select and group by. So I have to go right before group by and add a space, add where. I can use any column I want as my identifier. I'm going to go with A, where A is not null. Now when I press enter, that gap is gone. The great thing about the query function is that your whole report here is driven by a single function. Now if I don't want the sum of cash, I can just remove it from my function and then press enter, and I just get scenario by revenue. What if I also wanted to have division information up here? So I wanted the revenue by scenario and by division. This is where I can use the pivot functionality. Pivot is going to put my information in the rows here and create distinct columns. So if I go back to my query and see where pivot comes in, it's after group by. I'm going to go to the end here, add a space, and say pivot. Division is in column C, so pivot C, and press enter. And I have revenue by division and scenario. Now let's do another example where we take advantage of order by and the limit clauses. So let's say I want to get the division by total cash for only the actual scenario. And then I want to order this by cash. Let's write that down here. Start off with query. First thing is our data set. I'm going to select everything. Next comes our select statement. So in the end, what I want returned is division. So that's select C. I also want to get the sum of E. Now I don't need the comma, just a space because I'm moving on to the next clause. Now I want only where scenario equals actual. That's my where statement. So where A, because scenario is sitting in the A column, equals actual. But here you have to use the single quotes instead of the quotation marks. And so now I'm going to close the single quote. Because I'm also summing E, I need to group this by column C. I want total cash by division. So group by C. Now I'm going to close the bracket. But before I do that, don't forget the quotation marks. Press enter and I get division by the sum of cash. Now let's sort this by the sum of cash in descending order. That's when I can use order by. order by comes after group by. So I'm going to go to the end here, go with order by. I want to order this by sum of cash, that's sum of E. Default order is ascending order. I want this in descending order. The syntax is DESC, ampersand enter, and we have it in descending order. You can also update the formatting in the cells like we did before, or you can use the query function to add your formatting. That's when you can use the format clause. Format comes after all of these other ones that we've used so far. So I'm going to go to the end, go with format. What do I want to format? The sum of E. What type of formatting do I want? Well, your formatting also goes inside single quotes. And here you can use the same formatting options that you get inside custom formatting. To add a 1000 separator, I can go with hash, comma, hash, hash, and zero, and close that single quotes, and press enter, and I get my data automatically formatted. Another thing we can do is to change the label of this by using the label clause. Label comes before format. So let's go just before format, add our space here, put in label. The label we want to change is sum of E. What do we want to call it? In single quotes, let's call it total cash. Now when I press enter, this is updated as well. What does limit do? Limit restricts the number of your results to whatever you want. So limit comes after order by. That's our order by. Right here, we can say limit to, and we get the top two divisions. That wraps up our tutorial about the basics of the query function. Now there is a lot more you can do with this function. I cover the more advanced use cases of the query function in my complete Google Sheets online course. Link to it is in the description of this video. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to hit that thumbs up. And if you like what you see and you want to improve your skills in terms of office productivity, consider subscribing to this channel. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.